tonight. Demand for the COVID-19 shot no longer surpasses the supply. We've seen a decrease in people trying to get the vaccine across the state.
Starting this week, Texas will begin to ask the federal government only for doses that providers have ordered, rather than trying to get as many doses as possible. El Paso is no different. The county is shifting its strategy when it comes to the vaccine. ABC 7 JC Navarrete gives us a look at how the county is adapting. He joins us live in the studio. JC.
Eric, Steph, good evening. The excitement we once saw around the COVID-19 vaccine has begun to fade as more El Pasoans do get the shot. We're still a long way away from herd immunity, but the more shots that the county administers, the harder it is to find arms that are willing to get it.
For this week, UMC's hub did not request an allocation so that we can continue to administer the vaccines that we still have available. Our clinics that also did not receive an allocation for that same reason.
Reuben Vogt with UMC tells ABC 7 they're working to administer the vaccines they have on hand before they ask the state to send them more. To date, more than 668,000 doses of the COVID-19 vaccine have been allocated in El Paso. The county is changing their approach to the vaccine. Those long lines we saw months ago now look like this.
I think one of the things that we want to look at and explore is we were very successful that one Saturday with the Amber Alert that came out, and I call it the Amber Alert, is the mass notification system. And everybody that was part of that, they kind of loved it.
County officials are also shifting their strategy from the county coliseum to the pavilion next door as they resume operations at the coliseum for events like Disney on Ice. While they're moving out of the coliseum for now, they are on standby, always ready to distribute more vaccines.
So let's say they do decide to open up the bridges, and then, you know, we have people that can come from Mexico. We want to be ready, and we want to have mega sites. It would be a natural for them to go to the Coliseum, and I think as a community, most of us realize that if they're going to come in, we want them vaccinated as much as possible.
The city and county are shifting their focus to small events like the ones held over the weekend, where they provided vaccines at a downtown farmers market and in East El Paso. However, the amount of folks getting vaccines at those events is low.
It's probably most likely a lot of individuals that at those events have already received the vaccine or just are not going to be changing their mind.
Judge Samaniego says the only way we get to herd immunity is if we get those vaccine numbers up.
Hesitancy because, you know, you're complacent and you'd say, well, this is going to go away and maybe I don't need to get vaccinated. And that's, I believe that's the wrong way to look at it.
The county will be receiving 1,000 doses this week from the state. They will be allocating those Johnson & Johnson vaccines to the prison population. Eric. A new